Hi, I'm back with another video. For today, we are evaluating this integral here, the integral of 2 cos x plus 3 sin x divided by cos x plus sin x. And we can try doing this with a Weierstrass substitution where we let t to be equal to tan x over 2, and then we can try to substitute for cos x and sin x, you know, but I guess that's going to be very lengthy. So instead, we are going to do this by splitting the numerator. So let's go ahead and do that. So the way this works is that I'm going to split this numerator into two integrals. So I keep the denominator. So I have cos x plus sin x. Okay, this is with respect to x, of course, plus another integral still with the same denominator. So that's cos x plus sin x dx. Now let's think about it for a moment. What should we put here and here if we are to make these integrals easier to evaluate? So one of the easiest numerators to work with here could be if we have the derivative of the denominator. That's a nice one to work with because we know what this is going to be straight away. The integral of this is just the log of the denominator, okay? What numerator do you think we can put here to make this integral very easy to evaluate? Well, probably the best choice is to have the denominator itself so that we have a 1. That's pretty cool. So let's go ahead and have cos x plus sin x here. Now, of course, the left-hand side of this expression is not equal to the right-hand side because we just made up the denominators ourselves, so there is no reason why this should be equal. So just go ahead and make it equivalent, and then I'll put here some constants a and b such that, you know, we are going to find the values of a and b such that this expression is actually equal. So let's go ahead and do that. So consider this some kind of linear combination of integrals, you know, informally speaking. So of course the denominators are the same, so I'll just take care of the numerators only. 2 cos x plus 3 sin x equals a times the derivative of this, which is negative sin x plus cos x, plus b times what we have here is cosine of x plus sine of x. There we go. So we have 2 cosine of x plus 3 sine of x equals, so I'll collect the sines and cosines together. So I have here let's just say negative a sine x plus b. Sorry, let's just have the a here again, cos x plus b cosine of x plus b sine of x. Hanging, we're almost there. So 2 cosine of x plus 3 sine of x equals. So if I collect sine x together, I just write this. So if I collect the sine x together, this and this, then I'll just have here b minus a. Or if you want, you can write negative a plus b. And then if I collect the cosine x together, I'll have this and this, so I have a plus b. Oh, okay, so I should mention this is equivalent. So there we have it. So it turns out that this part here, the cosine part, should be, okay, so this part here should be equal to this part. And likewise, this part should be equal to this part. So we'll have a plus b. A plus b equals to 2, and then we have a minus b from here, or should say negative a plus b equals 3. And of course, from these two equations, we can find the values of a and b. By adding the two equations, you can already see that b is going to be, so that's going to be 0. 2b equals 5, so b is going to be 5 over 2. And if you substitute the value of b in any one of those equations, a is going to be negative 1/2. So let's go ahead and use these values to rewrite the integrals better. So our integral of, so what was that? 2 cos x plus 3 sine x divided by cos x plus sine x dx. Negative 1 half times the integral. So the derivative, here we have the derivative of cos x over sine x, which is negative sine x plus cosine of x divided by, so we have here cosine of x plus sine of x dx, plus we have 5 over 2, which is the value of b times, this is just a 1, so I'll just say the integral of dx, and this is going to be negative 1 half times, of course, this integral here is very straightforward. We know what this is. That's the natural log of the absolute value of cos x plus sine x plus 5 over 2 times x plus the constant of integration, of course. And this is what we call splitting the numerator. It's quite an easy method for evaluating this kind of integrals. And I'll be doing a follow-up video to make more examples about this. So this method, the beauty of it is that it allows us to choose the exact numerators that are going to make such rational functions very easy to integrate. So thanks for watching this video. If you like it, give me a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed to the channel, go ahead and do that. I'll see you in my next video. Bye.